grandfather, my mother's father, his grandfather came to Canada to work on the CPR railroad. Cheap labor.
When we saw these 铁钉的时候，首先都系睇俾我哋睇到以前诶华工嘅辛劳，而且呢啲铁钉咧就好多嘅，即系几百里路咁长。 最初咧係一個原住民帶我哋嚟呢度嘅，咁就係一個好震撼性。點樣可以做即係一個咁大嘅工程？
成個山窿都係真係好 solid 嗰啲馬石，所以以前真係唔知佢點爆，即係爆咗之後仲要揾啲大石頭出嚟。
好多呢啲咁嘅位置咧，係今日被遺忘嘅。 咁所以我哋唔願意我哋嘅歷史被遺忘，亦唔願意我哋嘅一個嘅遺址係即係好似放棄咗就算。
我想做個 comic book，comic book about racism， because a lot of stories people don't know about。 I want to talk about the feelings. Talk about the history of the Chinese to North America.
呢度系加拿大西部菲沙河谷嘅耶鲁镇，当年修建太平洋铁路嘅总部就坐落呢度。工人坐渡轮由卑斯省嘅维多利亚市沿菲沙河逆流而上，嚟到耶鲁镇上岸。工人当中大部分都系华工。
呢月咧開始水流又急又窄，即係條飛沙河啊！咁所以咧，佢哋就唔可以再架船再上啦。咁所以咧，佢哋就喺呢度就放低咗啲華工。咁而啲華工咧一落咗船之後咧，就喺呢度要開始以山路去進發，就去到即係要起鐵路嘅地方啦。
朱伟光系香港人，1977年佢移民到加拿大做建筑工程师。有一段时间，佢经常到铁路沿线城镇工作，所以听听埋埋唔少华工当年起铁路嘅故事，好多仲系第一次听闻，令佢为之动容。6年前，佢提早退休，专心去访寻百多年前华人喺铁路沿线留低嘅足迹。
我唔願意我嘅歷史被迷惘，亦我哋都希望咧就係、是、能夠去爭取到一個確認，咁同埋就係希望更多嘅華人去認識翻自己嘅歷史啦。
飛沙河谷穿流加拿大洛基山盟，大山將加拿大東西兩面阻隔。1870年代，西部的卑斯省要求当时加拿大政府建造一条贯穿东西的铁路，否则他们宁愿加入美国的版图。在连绵高山的恶劣环境下起铁路是极之艰巨的工程，但是当时的加拿大总理 John McDonald 一口答应。
Without a railroad, there was no reason for them to join because there was no means of transportation between the two coasts. The west coast of North America was a really north-south connections by water. And so without the railroad, the nation of Canada probably wouldn't be one that goes, you know, from sea to sea, from the Atlantic all the way to the Pacific.
太平洋铁路对加拿大意义重大，而取得兴建合同的是美国工程师 Andrew Onderdonk。 为减省成本，他想起当年修建美国铁路的时候他曾经用过的中国劳工。早在1865年，华人已经参与建造贯通美国中西部的中央太平洋铁路，当年参与的华工超过100,000人，他们人工低微，任劳任怨，令到整条铁路比原定计划提早7年完成。Andrew Onderdonk 决定在加拿大重施故技，於是派人到中國和美國加州招募華工，由1881年到1885年期間，在洛基山脈一帶工作的鐵路華工超過15,000人，每日工資只係得$1美金，是白人的一半。
The Chinese were paid less, partly because of racism.Against the Chinese, but also because they were more efficient. The Chinese labor was very useful, is because they were very reliable. Their discipline was self-discipline. They were very good at working in work gangs or groups because they were all relatives, generally, or they knew each other, or they were from the same areas.
飛沙河啲河水好急，嗰陣啲船咧上唔到去，咁所以就揾啲華工去做埋拉船上去。150個華工一齊拉咗100多吨嘅船，咁就沿住飛沙河，即係最急流嘅地方咧，硬硬車嘅上。即係你可以想像好斜山邊去掹架咁嘅船咧，其實係好風險嘅，即係唔知道有幾多人又跌咗落去啊之類啊咁。所以嗰陣即係起鐵路嘅時候咧，即係點解話？每一里起碼有幾多人死呢，就係咁解。就係
洛基山脈海拔3,000-4,000米，地勢險要，冬天更加係冰天雪地，氣候嚴寒。華工負責鐵路最險要嘅路段，但凡開山劈石、爆破呢類最危險嘅工作，都係由華工負責。
They were were using nitroglycerin, which was very unstable, and so there was lots of kinds of explosions that were accidental, and so people would die, or the explosives would go off too early, and they would die.
This 个山窿咧，就系大约1882年，啲华工啊帮手起呢条铁路嘅时候咧，唔通嘅，今日系唔通嘅。个原因就系因为起嘅时候咧，个爆破嘅工程咧就死咗好多嘅华工。所以他们都是不能够完成他们这一决。
可以想象到就是在峭壁原崖去走下去，将炸药塞落个窿口或者罅口去做的时候，然后点着引就即刻抬翻上去的时候，中间的过程就是很危险的。
Great-great-grandfather came to help build Canada's railroad. Well, 那時呢，他說中國很淒涼，那裡又沒有東西吃，又很亂。那時，外國那些人來蝦中國，ordinary people，also suffer a lot.So my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather brought his sons over, the two oldest sons, to Canada to work on the railroad.
Wong Hoi Tin is Canada's fifth generation Chinese. 130 years ago, his mother's great-grandfather from Guangdong Haiping hometown came to Canada to build the railroad.
乜嘢啦？系喎，老豆，60年前。系咯，呢个阿爷咯，爷好后生嚟噶啦。
往事逐渐淡忘，屋企年长一辈好少再提起当年嘅移民故事。不过黄海天反而觉得，作为华工嘅后代，佢有责任去保留呢段历史。5年前，佢放低建筑公司嘅工作。画漫画去重现翻呢段有血有泪嘅华人事迹。
佢1881年俾10年起，但佢哋抢埋晒啲中国人呢，4年半起好晒。1885年呢起好晒嘅铁车路咯，咪帮翻加拿大政府嗰时悭翻好多钱咯。The CPR had a big celebration at the last spike location, Craigellachie in BC.佢哋一個多就都冇多就我哋中國人，我哋啲華人咧影相咧，都話啲you know啊啲西人影埋曬啲相，我哋冇一個華人。
1885年11月7日，加拿大太平洋鐵路喺卑斯省克萊拉奇呢段路軌上打下最後一口釘。标志着贯通东西的铁路完成连接，西部的卑斯省终于纳入加拿大的版图。但是在这个意义重大的仪式上，竟然一个华人都没有被邀请出席。
一个很出名的相都是只是一班的白人在这里钉最后一钉，其实这个跟史实就不符的。因為實際上在起呢段鐵路的過程裏面，華人係佔了3/4的勞工的總數的，所以咧，即係華人應該是有一個舉足輕重的位置。
到加拿大起铁路的华工，大部分来自广东四邑和番禺的穷苦农民。他们很多都要向亲友借钱支付路费，目的只是希望可以在海外找到更好的生活。
My grandfather worked on the railway. It was very harsh and dangerous. The white man took the easiest one, and while the Chinese, they assigned the most dangerous job to the Chinese. It's working through the Rocky Mountain. It was very dangerous.
潘占元是退休工程师，他阿爷就是听到同乡讲金山容易揾食，于是他在18岁嗰年就离开家乡开平，嚟到加拿大起铁路。
The unfairness of the white people and not recognize the dangerous and important work the Chinese railway workers contributed in building Canada. At that time, Sir John A. Macdonald, he was Prime Minister of Canada, and the white people did not want the Chinese. Yet Sir John A. Macdonald said, "No Chinese, no railroad," which is true.
铁路完成，卑诗省就遇上经济萧条。华工因为工作勤奋，一向被白人批评嚟抢饭碗，于是政府就首先向中国移民征收人头税，借此阻止华工进入加拿大。
The irony is that the Chinese built the railroad and then created the transportation means to allowmass migration of Europeans, and as soon as the Europeans came, they looked around and they said, well, we have to get rid of the native people and the Chinese.
铁路完成之后，部分年老或者冇路费翻乡下的华工被迫滞留在飞沙河谷生活。朱伟光通过原住民的介绍，发现越来越多华工在河谷生活的痕迹。他还认识到早年的华人和原住民之间关系密切。
当加拿大政府引入这个人头税然后排华法的时候，目的主要上就是不想他妻女来得到这里，就等你哋班人自動嘅，正所謂真係講得唔好聽就斷子絕孫就算啦。嗰段嘅時期咧，就係一個同原住民通婚嘅比較大嘅時期啦。咁因為只有佢哋係接受華人啦，其他啲人唔接受華人噶啦。
They got married with the natives over.From after doing the railroad work and all that, we give about 65% to 70% of our people were mixed with the Chinese at the time. But the, like, see the generations now is really intermixed with other. My generation, Pat, to my mother's generation, is the last of the Chinese blood in us.
Bill Paul 是加拿大卑诗省的原住民，他泰麻那代有两个家人都是嫁给华人。原住民和华人百多年前同样受到白人歧视，结果反而造就了这两个民族的一段渊源。这两公里的石堆其实就是当年华工不断搬运河边石头而留下的。
You have to walk it in order to feel the specialness. You have to be open in your heart and your mind to feel the special effects of what the spirits leave behind here. And it's not just native spirits, it's Chinese spirits with our natives. That's what makes it special.
A little bit that way. It's got some interesting rock.
For 2 kilometers, this rock pile goes on.Seems like it's got a little bit of metal. Because since I walk it with my native pride, my Chinese pride.
起完铁路嘅时候咧，政府就设立人头税，就想希望啲华人就唔好再嚟啦。
咁而華人自己當然亦受盡歧視之後咧，咁佢哋嘅選擇就係一係咧就翻唐山，一係咧就係留喺呢度咧。咁當佢留喺度嘅時候，即係原住民嗰方面就係幫手，就係俾佢有土地。咁所以佢哋都能夠喺度安居樂業。咁然後即係當佢哋係有需要嘅時候，咁原住民方面又鋪喺佢哋呢個嘅土地安葬。
安葬早期華人嘅墓地，散落喺鐵路沿線，其中最完整嘅位於甘老市。50年前，由當地華人團體重新修葺，呢度百幾個墓穴，好多都無名無姓。一杯黄土埋葬的不单只是一段段华工血泪，还有他们的金山梦。19世纪末、20世纪初，在加拿大，华人没有投票权，不准买地，有部分行业甚至讲明不请华人。为了限制华人入境，还特别向他们开征人头税，由最初50加币大幅加到1903年的500加币，相等于一个华工2年的收入。
Canadian government imposed head tax only on the Chinese people. They did not impose it on any European country. My father had to pay $500 head tax for myself when I was 5 years old, and he paid $500 for my mother, and He did not have the money, but he borrowed the money from a relative. Even though this relative did not charge one penny for interest, it took my father 17 years to repay the loan.
排華情緒一發不可收拾。1907年，溫哥華唐人街發生暴動，白人到处破坏中国店铺，袭击华人。到1923年6月，加拿大国会更加通过排华法案，除了外交人员、商人和学生之外，华人一律禁止入境，就算家属想移民团聚，亦一律被拒门外。
The unjust law prevented anyone from China from immigrating to Canada.Chinese men who have already faced for 2 decades of stigma remaining separate from their family and was denied the right of subject of the country. This was unworthy of our country.
The human tragedies are that the people were separated, the families were separated, the children never got to know their father, and then when they wanted to bring them over because of the war, they couldn't. And because of that, many families were killed during the Second World War.So this is how it affects my family and also other families.
1864年出世我阿爺啊，
你仲記得你阿爺嗰時咧問你，有冇講你知嘛？來加拿大好辛苦嘛，貨車路嗰時好艱難嘛。
唔使講啊，辛苦。
唔使講，嗰時唔講嘢係嘛？
黃海天嘅家族裡面一共有12個成員俾過人頭税，外公關柱榮。就是因为排华法案的限制，令他没办法到加拿大和爸爸团聚，一个家庭从此各散东西。
你好少机会，以前加拿大不收你的人， 俾啲人嚟加拿大啊，係嘛？艱難啦、啊，雖然話人啊話加拿大話佢雖然話艱難大咯，艱難啊，話艱難大。
1940年咧，佢哋打仗咧，日本嚟打攻中國咧，好多人喺加拿大想帶佢哋家庭嚟加拿大，即唔好啊 ，just to save them from the war。The Canadian government did not allow any Chinese. And then when the war happened, they all starved or they all perished in the war. So it's very sad. It's a very sad time.
In 1939年9月，二次大战爆发，加拿大亦迅即向德国宣战，战情危急。不过，卑斯省同沙省政府仍然俾华人当兵。因为不想他们跟白人一样享有平等的公民地位。
The attacks and the exclusion acts, and there's also legislation against Chinese. You cannot vote. You cannot get a civil job. You cannot have a white collar job. So why bother? No, with Chinese, they had to go and pass laws.
年轻时候的黄金焕和其他土生土长的华裔一样，虽然受尽歧视，但是就一心入伍代国家出战。600多个华人最终获批准加入军队。战结束之后两年，呢条歧视华人嘅排华法案亦宣告废除。不过，公民可以享有嘅投票权就要等多几年先至正式批准。
It was a horrible experience to go to try to vote in uniform. Half the people say you can't vote, the other half say you can.The first time I voted, 10 years later, 1953. I didn't vote for the first time until I was 31 years old. It's crazy.
仲有啲仔女添。
黄海天嘅外公喺排华法案终止之后，尝试申请移民加拿大。当时佢49岁，已经同父亲分开24年。
Again, they wouldn't let him come over. My grandpa come over because at that time he's too old.Canada had a rule, even though you're allowed to come to Canada, you had to be below the age of 19. So my grandfather again was separated, and they were hoping that eventually they'll meet again, but unfortunately it never happened because my great-grandfather finally passed away in Saskatchewan in 1961, and they never met again.
一世咧見面嘅時間好短啊，
好短，
自己咧好即係好好痛心咯，冇咗啲機會再見到佢咯，係嘛？缺咗個遺憾呢件事咯，我攞佢寄啲相寄翻俾我，我喺我。
As I said, Chinese are always mistreated, always treated unfairly. We're the only country or group that had to pay head tax. Why just Chinese?
人头税、排华法案、不公平的对待，在老一辈华人移民心里面，这条刺一直令他们耿耿于怀。
let's go across country, you know. And guess what? Every guy that I rode with in the last, I've been riding since 1939. You figure it out.
八年前，黄金焕82岁，但系佢就揸住佢嘅电单车，从西岸到东岸，沿途不断呼吁政府平反人头税，而且要追认翻当年因为起太平洋铁路而牺牲嘅1400位华工嘅贡献。
Family and all my friends and the veterans group. Everybody said no, 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 no. Nobody agreed with it. And I made up my mind that's the way I am. The more opposition there is, the harder I try. If you want to change something,Go for broke. You want a breakthrough? Go for broke.
黄金焕的行动引起当地媒体的关注，亦都将分散各地的受害家庭团结一起。一场平反之旅进入白热化阶段。
Redress Express train was a great historical success, publicizing awareness and recognition of Chinese railway workers across the country.
2006年6月21号，一列名为“平反列车”嘅火车由西部温哥华开出。沿途接载年老的人头税受害人和家属，向东部渥太华的国会山庄进发。他们还准备将当年纪念太平洋铁路员工的最后一口铁钉亲手交给总理哈帕。
That was a turning point. I'm very proud of that. There's some people say that.It may not have happened if I didn't make that ride. And raise awareness.
My mom said, 好远好远啊，那些鬼佬呢，不给我们去嘛，这样咯，因为我们是中国人嘛。
真係又係唔啱，緊嚟到你啲轉路主皮，運手銀後水而轉。
我老豆佢就係話，希望你媽媽長命百歲，政府咧一定要叫政府攞份啲錢咁咯。呀，佢話一定要叫政府攞份啲錢。
Thank you. 於翁係瑞金子喺我爸爸嗰度1914年三月發出俾佢嘅。就呢張紙咧，當年咧係500蚊。
劉來增係移民第二代，爸爸1914年問同鄉借錢交人頭税500加幣先至可以入境。當年500蚊可以喺加拿大買到2間屋。佢估計華人繳交嘅人頭税多達2300萬加幣，相當於太平洋鐵路嘅總建造費。
Anyway， 即係即係嘅意思就話，呢張紙係我哋咧接到呢張紙嘅時候咧，係基本上係當紀念品，並唔係話要期望啲乜嘢。但係喺呢個運動之中嚟講，就希望佢能夠了結，了咗一個心願。
咁啊，瞓埋一陣啊。
OK，
平等是要自己爭取回來的，因為如果你不去爭取，沒有人會送這個權力給你的。
吳瑤瑤是香港移民，20年前在加拿大讀法律，但從未聽過排華法案這段歷史。後來接觸到當地華人團體，了解多了，才開始參與組織這場平反運動。
你一系咧就要靠傳媒，一系就要靠社區力量，一系就要靠去即係施加政府嘅壓力，一系就用法律，一系就上街遊行。
Mr. Prime Minister, on behalf of all of us, for this chance to share in making Canadian history.
2005年嗰陣時咧，當時咧保守黨咧就可能會即係贏到個大選啦。咁而我哋即係參與呢個平反運動嘅人，就用嗰個政治嘅機會，就向保守黨嘅佢哋嘅黨魁問佢：你會唔如果你當選嘅話，你會唔會即係對提出呢嘅平反嘅結果？咁就因為咁樣咧，就先至咧就令到個保守黨嘅政府當時就話：如果我哋當政嘅話，我哋就會平反。
Today, I want to acknowledge the courage of the Prime Minister and this government to do the right thing and apologize for the head tax and for the Exclusion Act.
It was the day everybody was waiting for, so we were all happy that it finally happened.
Today is an important day, one in which we turn the page on a sad period of our history.
I thought it was very, very good, you know, like they did that. And it made you proud that they finally did that.
That is what our government did today by issuing a formal apology to the Chinese Canadian community for the head tax and expressing our deepest regret for the Exclusion Act. Ga na dai dohi.
Prime Minister Harper.佢講話加拿大悼念，嗰時嗰啲人好開心，又有一冚，又一冚，又一個吸收。I look at this and I say this is very important for today's leaders to recognize the wrongs of the past, and it shows leadership. He finally apologized, and for that we accept his apology. I mean, very touched that it happened, and that was very meaningful.
总理向华人致歉之后，政府随即向仍然在生的785名人头税受害人或者遗孀，每人赔偿20000加币，大约港币150000。但系呢个方案引起部分家属不满。
What has happened is that 785 families received the symbolic redress, but there's 4,000 families who have registered with CCNC seeking redress.What about these other 3,000 families, right? They also paid the head tax.
即係話安慰下咁啫，係嘛？你話補償咧，佢就補償唔到噶啦，係嘛？但係仲有好多阿公阿婆去咗世喎，咁啊佢以前冇係過喎，咁你話啦，係唔係公平咧？
俾咗個再生嘅，唔俾個嘅死者嘅，呢個在公平上嚟講咧係講唔通嘅。 很多人以為我哋好貪婪，其實我哋唔係錢嘅問題，係主要就係公義嘅問題，並唔係話佢一萬兩萬嗰呢個數字嘅問題，而係話公平嘅問題。應該係一張紙一個退出，一張紙你有張紙，尤其是證明你係佢嘅後人，你哋有權可能得到佢嘅遺產。
好多嘢噶，阿姐啊，我拎嗰啲咩嚟俾你啊？嗰啲 passport 啊，样样嘢有啊。阿哈柏政府咧就有张道歉嘅书，同埋咧有张 check 啊，20,000蚊。我妈咪攞到啫，但系咧我心都好噏噶。因為我要負起嗰個責任啊嘛，我有份參加嚟到平反啊嘛，係咪？我本身同我老豆就實現咗啦，未實現仲有好多人啊！嗰啲受過人後歲嘅困擾，俾錢受過苦過咧，未平息，未安息，未安息。呀，雖然佢係過咗身啫，佢哋未安息，個心中。仲有一條刺喺度。
In this province, the Chinese have suffered a century of discrimination. Now, this country or this province is how old? How many people know?
平反人頭税運動告一段落之後，朱偉光四出去學校演講，爭取將華人同原住民嘅貢獻寫入教科書，期待加拿大經常強調嘅種族共融文化可以落實。確認華人對當地嘅貢獻，
我哋覺得即係喺呢個嘅尋求復和過程裏邊咧，首先要知道真相啦，啊歷史嘅真相，因為如果大家連真相都唔知嘅時候咧，有咩好復和啫，係嘛？
125 years, the celebration of the completion of the Canadian Pacific Railway.So the CPR had a big celebration at the last spike location, Craigellachie in BC. And when they have a celebration, again, 没一个中国人在这里，这么衰的，you know. Even now, they don't recognize the Chinese contribution.
白宮究竟經歷過一段嘅咩嘅辛勞？呢班人其實佢點解過嚟咧？就係為下一代啦，即係佢希望係為下一代供養咗下一代啊，俾下一代有個 chance。咁但係而家問題就話下一代嚟咗啦，再下一代都嚟咗啦，但我哋有冇去明白上一代所做嘅犧牲同貢獻咧？咁